This conference will now be recorded.
We will learn standard report. Okay, we will learn how to create an advanced report from scratch. We will learn how to add filters, prompts, and then we will also learn about security. Report security, how do you create security? How do you share a report? How do you transfer a report? And of course, scheduling, yeah. And then we will learn calculated fields. So we are not restricted to just these set of calculated fields. We will learn around 10 to 15 calculated fields, not just these which are mentioned here. Apart from this, we will learn more number of calculated fields, which we will cover in our classes. These calculated fields are basically related to the reports. So once we are done with reports, you will be able to create your own custom reports. Your own custom reports for your own projects. And then we will learn, we will start with integrations. We will learn, we'll have some theory part on integration. And we will learn about how do we use these reports in our integration. Okay, we will learn about web services, theoretical part once again. And then we will learn about different types of integrations. You have business process integration, you have EIBs, you have core connectors. We will learn all of it. Okay, here these are all different types of EIB integrations which we will learn. These are the types. You have inbound, you have outbound integrations. This is what we will learn. We will learn how to use those reports which we created in these integrations. We will learn basic of XML. I will repeat again, this class is for Workday integrations. It is not an XML XSLT conversion class. Okay, which means Workday doesn't require development as in coding. But yes, there is a little bit of coding involved where you convert XML, which is the output file of report. It's an XML format. We convert XML to XSLT. Okay, XSLT is another language. We convert XML to XSLT. So this class is not to learn coding. Okay, we will teach you the basics of XML. We will teach you how to use the XSLT into the integration. Okay, but the learning of coding would be at your end. Okay, you will have to learn it yourself. We will teach you the basics as how to do it. Am I clear with this particular topic?
Yes.
Okay. Then we will learn different types of core connector. Very important topic in Workday integrations where you get most of your questions from. Core connector, we will learn one type of CCW, which is called a CCW, core connector worker, which is the base for all the other integrations, okay, in core connector. If you learn CCW and you learn how to configure it, the same process is applicable for any other core connector integration. Okay, the fields might be different, of course, based on various things, but the configuration remains the same. The interview question remains the same. So we will learn CCW type core connector integration, and we will learn how to add securities to those integrations which we create. So this will be our topic. We will not be covering Studio. Studio is a totally different side of Workday integration. It is out of Workday tenant. Okay, it's a different application which is connected to Workday, and it's a costlier application, so we are not going to learn Workday Studio. We will cover rest of all the other Workday inbuilt integrations. Okay, like EIB, core connector, various types of EIBs. We will learn only these three types of integration: document transformation, business process configuration. We will learn core connector, CCW. We will learn EIB, where it has three types of other integrations in EIB. Okay, these are the ones. Any questions so far?
Shridhar, do you cover APIs as well in this, like web services?
Yes. Yeah, we will have a theory session about APIs. Yes, sure.
Do you work on studios as well?
No, we do not work on studio.
Okay. No, I'm not asking about this class. I mean, on your experience, do you work on studios as well?
No, I have not worked on studio.
Okay.
Okay, so. Yeah, so APIs and all will be a theory session as how, what is a public web services, where do you find it, how do you look at public web services, APIs, and how do you use all of that in the integration here, and how do you use all of that here. So we learn all of that, right? So let's get into the demo session now. Right, so I have a PPT prepared. Let's start with this. So we're going to see Workday integration overview. Is my screen visible?
Yes.
Okay. So The screenshot which you see on the screen is the integration architecture overview of Workday, and this is how Workday integration actually works. Okay, this is how it works. We have users, we have systems at one end, and then we have our servers at the other end. So the connecting medium is internet, where it is connected with, there is a conversation between the user and the server using HTML, and then there are servers which are responding back in XML kind of language. As I told you, whenever you create a report, which is in basic English, when you generate an output, it turns into XML. Okay, you get an output in an XML format. Those XML formats are quite readable. Okay, you can read those XML formats, what is written in that. It is very simple, like employee name, employee ID, employee address, which location he stays. So all of this is quite simple to read, but it is an XML format. Now, these XML formats are usually, in integration, are usually transferred from one system to another system. But if the XML is not accepted by the other system, in that case, we will have to convert it to a text format. So that conversion part is where our programming comes. That's where we will write some basic codes to convert XML into XSLT. And this XSLT will be generating a text output file when the integration runs. Okay, so now, here you have something called as OMS, Object Management System. And then you have something called as Persistence Store. So your questions are not gonna come, as in your interview question is not gonna come from this particular page for sure. Okay. So this is just for our understanding. And to know how the data is pulled from OMS and Persistence Store when user gives any kind of instruction. When I say instruction, when user gives any kind of runs a report, when user runs an integration, so how the data is getting pulled and from where, that is what this slide is talking about. Okay, so everything is stored at Persistence Store. From Persistence Store, it goes to OMS. And if it is a UI server, or if it is an integration server, what is a UI server? UI server is basically, let's take an example of, let's say you've logged in into tenant, okay, Workday tenant, and you have given a command saying you want to find some worker XYZ. Okay, in search box, you have typed XYZ and you have hit enter. So what will the Workday system do at the back end? How will it pull the data and give you? This is how it does. Okay, it goes to the UI server, converts that into XML, goes to Persistence Store, and gives you the output. The same thing is applicable for integration as well. When you write an integration, as in when you configure an integration, the integration will go to integration server. It will convert to XML and it will speak in XML language with persistent store. It will pull up the data and it will give you back the output. Now, when I say it will do a conversation in XML with persistent store or OMS, what all data do you capture in integration? So integration is basically connecting two systems. Okay, that is what integration. There is system A, system B. So if you want to connect these two systems, or if you want any data to be transformed from A to B or B to A, there should be some kind of connection, right? So that connection is what integration is. Now, this connection will be for various reasons. You might have to transfer worker information from one system to another system. You might have to transfer payroll related, your salary, your compensation related data from one system to another system. You might have to transfer benefit details from one system to another system. Okay, so that's the kind of conversation is happens between two systems, and this is because of the integration. And this happens through XML format only, unless and until the system is not supporting XML. In that case, we use XSLT, which converts it to text format. Okay, any questions here on this screen? Okay, moving on. Now, this is our integration cloud platform. Okay, Workday cloud platform integration. This is how it looks. As I was telling you, you use integration for what? You use integration for payroll, you use integration for benefits, or any other purposes, LDAP, AD, any other purposes. Okay, so what and how does it work when it comes to APIs? Okay, custom APIs and web service APIs. So what is an API? All that we will discuss during class. Okay, this is just to give you an overview of how Workday integration works. Okay, so you have this Workday application, you have public API and custom API, and they have this conversation, you know, data transferred, any cloud application data or any other application data transferred in and out. Okay, as I told you, system A and B, in and out, the data is getting transferred in this process. Okay, as you see on the screen, using public API or custom APIs. And in Workday, we have some custom integrations which we build and some integrations which are already there. We call that as Cloud Connect integration. Okay, those templates are already there in Workday itself, like CCW template, all that is there in Workday. We will learn how to create, use those templates. We will learn how to create our own template as well. So Workday works on software as a service. We already are aware of. So that's a question, interview question. What is Workday? So Workday is a software as a service. And when it comes to integration, public web services are available in Workday. And we request and response XML. So what is this public web service? We talk about public web service, custom APIs, right? So please write it down or remember this well. When we say public web service, it means you are requesting Workday for something, and based on your request, Workday is giving you a response on something. Okay, that is in XML format. Both of this happens in XML format. That is public web services. What is custom web services? Custom web services is nothing but the report which we create. I showed you the content, right? The where we are going to create the report. So those reports, we need to enable it so that we can use it in integration. And when we use it in integration, it becomes custom web services, okay, custom APIs. Now, this is the integration I was talking about, system A, system B. An integration is a bridge between two systems, Workday or any other system. Now, there are two types of integration in Workday, inbound and outbound. Okay, these are the only two types of integration. Now, this can be divided into subtypes that we will talk when we are discussing Workday. Right now, there are two types of integration, inbound and outbound. So always remember, to avoid confusion, keep Workday as a base. Okay, we are working for Workday, we are learning Workday, so Workday is our base. Anything which goes outside Workday is outbound. Anything which comes inside Workday is inbound. Okay, I'll repeat again. Anything which goes outside Workday is outbound. Anything which comes inside Workday is inbound. And that's what you see here on your screen. Integrations can be outbound, where data is exported from Workday and sent to target system. These are some basic data, demographic data, payroll data, benefits data. And we use a specific tool called as Oxygen. Okay, there's an Oxygen tool which we'll download to convert XML to XSLT or to view an XML. Okay, now this is an outbound, I would say how an outbound architecture of Workday works. Okay, this is the screenshot for that. So what actually happens is, you see the screenshot at the right bottom. You see there are worker information, payroll information, talent and finance information. Okay, these are all the some examples of some data which would be transferred from Workday system to some other system, okay, XY system. Now, how does this happen? Okay, so as you see here on the screen, those data is converted into a web service and a report, and it is sent through FTP, SOAP, or attachment. These are different methods wherein you will use to send the data to third-party system, right? When you're working for a live project, so in live project, all this will be active, okay? FTP, SFTP, you'll have those IDs, addresses, you'll have username and password to transfer the data. So you'll use any of the system which the client is asking you to do it. You will not do it as per your wish, okay? The client will give you all the information, every single thing client will be informing you. So once the client tells you that they want the data to be transferred to FTP or SFTP server, you will simply create your report. You will use an integration, as in you will configure an integration, outbound integration, and you will use SFTP method to send the data to external system, XYZ system. That's how our integration outbound works. There are some common words which we would use in Workday. Okay, you see that on your screen. We will be using business objects. Why business object? Because everything in Workday is based on business object. What is this business object? The business object is nothing but, it is an object which refers or which stores some kind of data. Okay. For example, business object is worker name, employee name, right? So employee name stores what? Name of the employee, right? Employee ID. What is employee ID? It stores employee ID number, address, home address. It stores home address of the employee. Right? So those are all business objects, and everything in Workday is based on business object. Everything in Workday is based on business object. Then we have report as a data source. When we say data source, these set of information, these set of business objects, okay, information of these business objects are stored in a data source. When I say data source, it means it is a field. I would not say a field. It is something which will contain specific information, like a worker information, like a terminated worker information, like a retired worker information. These are all specific information, a set of information which is applicable only for that group. Okay, so a data source is basically kind of a group which we will use in our report in order to pull that data out. Say, for example, I want all active worker report. So I will use a data source, all active worker. Let's say I want everything in Workday, all the workers in Workday. So I will use a data source called as all active and terminated employee data source. So these are data. We will see that when we are going into Workday. Then you have report class report fields. These are nothing but there are different types of fields, custom fields and all that. That's what we will use. Custom fields means calculated fields. Then you have related business objects. Now I told you that these are business objects, right? So there is some subdivision called as related business object, which comes under a business object. Okay? These are primary ones and these are related objects. Then we have instances. Okay, instances is nothing but let's say the example is dependent. Okay, dependent is an instance where it has multiple. You have multiple, you can have multiple dependents. You can have spouse, you can have child. Okay. So those are all instances. Now this screenshot talks about inbound integration. So anything which comes inside Workday is an inbound integration. Integrations can be inbound where data from the target system is imported into Workday. Any sort of data. Time tracking, job application, payroll input, all that comes into Workday. Now this is the architecture of inbound integration. You see now it is the other way. Here we are using SFTP server to feed the data inside Workday. What type of data? We are getting employee, payroll, finance, those sorts of data. So when the third party integration uses SFTP server to send the data inside, it goes and gets saved in these business objects. Employee, payroll, wherever it is applicable, it goes and gets automatically updated there. These are the different types of integrations. We have Workday has several tools for building these bridges between Workday and external system. Cloud Connect for integration, custom integration built using the integration cloud platform. Here we are. These are the different types of integrations which we will be learning. We will learn about Cloud Connect. Okay. Sorry, not Cloud Connect. We will learn about Core Connector. Okay. These are workers, organization, or sorry. We will learn about worker. And when we learn about Core Connector worker, it will be the same for organization or payroll or benefit. Okay, the configuration remains the same. Although the fields are different, the configuration will be the same. We have we will learn about custom integrations like APIs, EIB, document transformation. We will not go through Studio, but we will learn APIs, EIBs, and document transformation and Core Connector worker. Now this screenshot talks about what is a Cloud Connect. So we see here, Cloud Connects are nothing but pre-built integration to common applications and service provider that extends Workday functionality in certain functional area. So in simple term, Core Connector is core connector integration is nothing but there are predefined, pre-built templates available in Workday itself, which is given by Workday. Okay. We use those templates, we do some configuration, and we send the data to third-party system. Now, this kind of configuration can be done for benefits, can be done for payroll, can be done for compensation or worker information, any of it. Okay, because we are using some existing template, doing some small configuration, customizing it based on client's requirement and sending the data. So this is core connector. Okay, and it requires a bit of coding if you require conversion from XML to text file or any other format. See, this is what I was talking about. If you want core benefits, to send the data for benefits, you already have the template available. The template will be there already, okay, in Workday system. You just have to pick the right template and start your configuration. So these are all the packed integration. Packed integration means they will send medical data, dental data, they'll send benefits data. Here, there's an integration called as benefits connector. If nothing of this works, then we'll use benefit connector to create the integration from scratch. So we learn all of this, and I'll show you how and where it is in Workday. These are some basic types of cloud connectors. As I told you, we will learn only core connector worker. Rest of it, the configuration remains the same. Okay. Now these are Workday, again, a continuation. In addition to packed integrations and core connectors, you can make custom integrations. We will make these custom integrations. We will build an API, we'll build a EIB, we will build a document transformation. We'll learn what is what, okay? We will learn all the interview questions from these topics, except for Studio. So what is an API? Application Programming Interface. Then API covers these two things, okay? Reports as a service and web services. So reports as a service, as in we create an advanced report, we use it in our integration. That is called report as a service. Okay, I'll repeat again. We create a report, advanced report. We use that report in our integration. That is report as a service. Workday Web Services is nothing but we use REST web service or SOAP web services, which is already there in Workday system, to import or export data. Okay, which is sending the data outside Workday or getting the data inside. We have EIB, which is Enterprise Interface Builder. This is one type of integration. We have inbound and outbound both. Okay, we will learn how to create an Excel sheet for inbound. We will learn how to send the data outside using, we will learn how to send the report which we created. We'll convert that into an integration. We'll learn how to send the data outside in EIB, Enterprise Interface Builder. This is nothing much. Yeah, document transformation. This is another type of integration which we will learn. This integration is used to convert a document to a different format. Okay, you can use proprietary Workday, not that. Okay, use XSLT to convert output from XML to text format. So if you want to convert XML to text format, we will use this particular integration. We will learn how to configure it. See the first line, takes XML output from connector or a custom report and transform it, allowing you to customize the output. okay, this belongs to studio. So what are the different uses of integration? Why do we need to know or learn integration? So besides allowing Workday to integrate with external system, you can use this for adding file attachments. You know, these integrations are used for file attachments or loading worker photos or any custom objects or any worker information from one system to another system. So these are the uses of Workday integration. Yeah, these are the other uses: probation period extension, or finding anything else. Yeah, so that's about it from my end, guys. Do you have any questions for me which I can take?
Srikant, why were you our interview guidance approach?
Come again?
How would be the interview guidance and approach will you be following?
Interview?
Guidance and approach.
Yeah. So when I'm taking the session, I will tell you the interview questions which will be asked, possible interview questions which could be asked from the particular topic. Yeah. So you can make note of that. So I think that should be helpful for you.
Will you be providing a full list of interview questions at the end, comprising all the
full what?
Full list of interview questions from all the.
I will be providing the questions on the spot itself. When I'm covering a topic, I will give you the set of questions from that topic, and you can make note of it. So I think you can collate all that together in a separate file. Yeah, so it will be easy for you to grasp, you know, if you talk about interview questions in the front, at the beginning or at the end, you might not remember what actually we are discussing. But if you write down the question when we are talking about the points, you'll know what we are actually talking. Okay. Any other questions for me?
Tenant access for practice.
Yeah, sure. You will have tenant access. You will be provided tenant access. You will be provided documents as well. Okay, there are a set of different documents which Suresh will provide you, which will have small details. Theoretically. Yes, Anand.
Yes. Can you also cover basics, you know, not in detail, but just a little bit for somebody, you know, who didn't go through, you know, basic HCM classes. That's going to be a big help. You know, just the definition and, you know, common used words and those kind of stuff that help.
Yeah, sure. What we would do is, and when we are starting with reports. Okay, we start with reports. Okay, we start with reports here. So when we start with reports, anything which comes up related to HCM.
Right.
Yeah, anything comes up related to HCM, I'll explain it to you.
Okay, all right.
And, okay, if nothing comes up related to HCM, then I will not explain it to you, okay?
Sure, no problem. Yeah, you know, anything that's related to, you know, that's pertaining to the topic, you know. Do you give daily, you know, assignment or something like that where we can have some hands-on?
Okay, yeah, that's an important point here. There would not be an assignment, but whatever we do in the class, okay, whatever we discuss in the class or I show you in the class, I want you to replicate it. That is more than enough for practice, and that is more than enough for you to take up an interview. Okay, if you replicate what I do, because I'm going to do some, show you some reports, I'll create one report, I'll create calculated fields, which are used live in the project. Okay, I will create integration which are used live in a project. So if you replicate the same, that is sufficient enough.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, yes, Lalita.
Hello, Sudhya. Lalita here.
Yeah.
See, I have a query. I miss this HCM. You're taking me to integration, but I miss the HCM. Do we have any session for HCM for demo?
Yeah, I think you have a demo session for HCM as well. Yeah, I think there should be some recording which is available. My own recording. I think we'll share that with you and you can just go through it. It is my own recording.
That is for HCM, right?
Yes, that's for pure HCM. This is for integration.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Okay, it takes 35 hours for integration course. Here on the screen, you will see only 25 to 30. It takes 30 to 35 hours. Right, any other questions for me?
Also, Srikant, whatever you're covering for the day, can you provide a little bit material? You mentioned before that there are going to be little basics in the material. To what extent do you provide in the in the material? The more detail, the better it is.
No, of course. See, when we talk about material, the materials are not something which we prepare. Okay, the materials will be directly the workday workbooks. Okay, so every small detail, every small topic, every small word you will find in that material. It will be like a book, okay, a PDF file with lots of pages, 200, 300, 400 pages. So it has all small information which you can find in that.
Okay. I mean, is there any necessity for do you provide any other paper material or PDF apart from from the workday thing?
No, nothing else apart from that workday PDF file workbook. Nothing else. I have my internal notes which I would not be sharing, but you can write it down. And apart from that, you have workday workbooks only, which you will get.
Okay.
No, after the classes, you will be able to understand those workbooks quite easily.
Okay, all right.
Hello, Srikant.
Yes, sir.
See, I have a question. See, we have success factors and a number of sources with the management. How it going to help us work day? Why to choose the work day? How it will be like we have an experience with the human resource? In what way like we can implement this one?
Okay, so you talk about success factor. Are you planning to learn success factor? As in, have you kept that as an option?
We have very few options for management. Then why to choose the workday? Like how it gonna how we can apply this for our management?
Okay, so first thing, are you going to learn workday? Are you going to work for a workday project or are you going to implement a workday project?
We are going to work with the workday projects.
Okay, you're going to work for the workday project, right? So, see, when we talk about this workday and success factor, workday is quite simpler. Let me show you.
Okay.
Right. Quite simple when I say it talks about UI. I talk about UI. Okay. UI is quite simpler. Concepts are quite simpler. And it is easy to remember, I would say.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll show you the UI.
See, it is like user-friendly.
Sorry?
You mean to say it is like user friendly?
Yeah, it is user friendly, and the UIs are very user friendly, and I would say it is cloud based completely. Okay, so SuccessFactor, I'm not sure, but Workday is cloud based. So whatever or how much ever data or details you add or remove, everything is cloud-based. You don't need to maintain any extra server or any extra drive. Everything can be stored in Workday itself.
So totally it isn't a cloud, right?
Yes, everything is cloud, like a Google Drive.
Okay. Thank you.
So that's the reason Workday is booming. It is in demand, lots of opening for Workday. Like login. Yeah, this is how it looks. This is Workday tenant. When you log in, this is how it will look. Okay. This is how it looks, and you have various options here. You go to your profile, and this is how your profile will look when you log in into Workday. It's quite user friendly, and it has all the information related to an employee. You can see compensation, contact details. On the left side, you can see compensation, benefits, absence. All of this information in one single application. You can even configure various modules here. If you want time of absence, or you want compensation related, time absence, learning, recruitment. All of this you can do in one single module itself, or one single application itself, sorry. In Workday itself, you can do multiple modules. You don't need separate logins. That's the use of Workday, and everything gets stored in cloud. Nothing is system, like you don't have to save it in your laptop. You just have to log in, and any changes you make or any configurations you do, any reports you create, everything is saved here in Workday itself. If you want to find another employee, this is how the search works. You know, if you want to find an employee, let's say I want to find somebody called John. Okay, so I can find John. I can view his profile. Like, understand there are different types of tenants. Okay, this is a type of tenant which has an access to view others' profile. Okay, usually what happens is I cannot view somebody else's profile. Right, this tenant has an access. See, I can view his profile, I can view who's the manager, his location, his compensation, everything. These are all dummy data, okay, nothing in real, just for practice purpose. If I want to find an integration, I'm not sure if there is any integration. Okay. Here it is. There's already an integration CCWC. This is how the integration configuration looks. Somebody has created and configured this integration. See, this is how it looks. You can configure the integrations from here. You can launch it from here. Launch and schedule. This is how integration runs. This is the page where integration will run. So after you do all the configurations, you come back here, launch it, and then run the integration.
Okay.
Usually when you run such kind of integration like project, it takes long time. It does not take like 31 seconds. It takes a long time, very long time, maybe hour or maybe days, one day, if it's completed. You have the output file generated. The output XML. Let me open that view. Sure, I have oxygen. This is how the XML format looks. See, this is the output file. And this is looking a little clumsy because I've used it in Notepad. There is a specific tool called Oxygen, which you use it in your real-time project. When you open it in Oxygen, it will not be so clumsy. It will be in a proper format like this. Okay, it will be in proper sequence, I would say. Like this. It will be one after the other. Now it is a Notepad, so it is everything dumped here. You see the information, you see employee ID. You see this employee ID is here. Then you will find worker name here. See, worker name. These are all the informations you will get from the reports or from integration, and the data will be transferred. Any other questions for me? Before we end the session.
Srikant, are you currently working?
Yes, I'm working with an organization.
Okay, all right.
As a techno functional consultant.
Okay, may I know, like, for how many years, you know, just general?
I have six years of experience in Workday. Altogether, oh. I have 12 plus years of experience in IT.
Oh, wonderful. Okay. All right. How many in integration side?
I would say 3 years I've been working with integration.
Okay, wonderful. All right.
Right, so if we do not have any questions, we'll end the session and you can contact Suresh for further process. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
This conference will now be recorded.